Anytime you cut a clip with audio to trim it, you unintentionally create a pop or click. But thankfully, Crossfades will fix this problem, and DaVinci Resolve just recently added the best way to add a whole timeline's worth of fades that I've ever seen in a video editing program. Bam! It's that easy. And it didn't undo any of the fade work I had done earlier in the editing process. So today, we're going to do a quick and deep dive into everything that you need to know about adding audio fades to smooth out your mixes. You'll finally understand when and why you choose one fade shape over another, but make sure to stick around until the end to also learn a hack for batch removing transitions in DaVinci Resolve. To use this new feature, open the Fairlight page. It has a music note. Go to the Fairlight menu. Click the Batch Fade Settings. This box gives us so much control, but I love the Override Existing checkbox the most. Leave this unchecked, and it won't undo any of the work that you've already done in the Edit page. This is so simple but so useful because I'm generally not going to apply batch fades in the Fairlight page until I'm close to finishing editing my video. This is a final finishing polishing step. Avid has this ability, but it doesn't have all this extra control that Blackmagic has. Turn on all three orange switches. Fade in and out are for clips that aren't touching another clip on the timeline. I like linear fade in and exponential fade out set to 3 frames. You can also change the timeline measurement to milliseconds instead of frames if you're more of a sound guy, but I think in frames. Exponential fade outs are a great way to get a gentle music taper. Now, the middle crossfade is for clips that are touching each other on the timeline. These are good for Frankenbiting words together to help make a person sound more intelligent or concise than they initially sounded, maybe like me. It's perfect for YouTube-style jump cuts, but crossfades are also perfect for transitions or ducking music, background room tone and ambience, that sort of thing. The one catch for crossfades is that you're going to need some handles. That's the part of the clip before or after the part that you see in the timeline. It's just like a visual cross dissolve, just remember that adjacent clips need handles to create a transition, or you're going to end up with a warning. Choose equal power and set the length to 2 frames. 2 frames is usually enough samples to cover the zero crossing issue, which I'll explain shortly. Click apply and your fade settings are dialed in. To batch add all the frames, you need to make a selection. I select the entire timeline by going to the first frame with a home shortcut key, mark I on the keyboard. Now choose the Range Selection tool, R is the keyboard shortcut, and click an empty track header section. This method lets you choose selections one track at a time, but you could also drag a marquee over all the clips easily with the Range Selection tool instead. Now go to the Fairlight menu and choose Apply Batch Fades, and your video is going to sound so much better. You can assign keyboard shortcuts to these commands by opening up Keyboard Customization. Type Batch into the search box. Click into the keystroke field. I like to use Shift Command F to apply fades and Control Option Command F to bring up the batch fade settings. So you're thinking, great, what's the big deal? Why should I care about adding fades to every single cut? Let me briefly explain. Sound has an up and down waveform shape, you probably already know that, and it crosses a middle line called the zero crossing. If you cut on a zero crossing, there's no problem at all. But in any video editing software that I've ever seen, you can't cut on a zero crossing because you're limited to video frames and not individual audio samples. Usually there's 48,000 audio samples in a second, which is a lot more than 24 video frames in a second. So if the waveform gets interrupted by a cut and it isn't smooth anymore, it creates a pop or click when it's played back. Some brilliant genius came up with the effect called the audio fade or crossfade, which smooths out the samples, so that way there isn't a jump from one side of the cut to the other. The other way to fix a pop is actually by redrawing the waveform, which you can surgically do in Fairlight, but that's for another tutorial and not something you can batch super quick like fades. Fades are like a quick band-aid, so no one will be able to hear the cuts underneath. The other big question I always had was, which type of crossfade should I pick? Under batch fade settings, there's 2 main presets. There's equal power and equal gain. Honestly, just stick to those two 99% of the time and choose equal power, sometimes called constant power, pretty much all of the time, except for one exception. This type of crossfade has a +3 decibel bump in the curve to maintain perceived volume throughout the crossfade. It has to do with the logarithmic nature of sound falloff, but just know this is the setting you want to pick most of the time. Now only choose equal gain, sometimes called constant gain, for music loops and cues, tone loops, anytime you could have a phase issue when they're combined. You'll actually hear the bump in audio if you choose equal power option when crossfading matching tones, so just be mindful of this, and equal gain has your back in this situation. Batch applying fades is not new to DaVinci Resolve, but having this kind of control and overriding or not overriding existing fades is new, and it's extremely useful, but it needs to be done in the Fairlight page. If you're an edit page only guy and you don't mind losing some of that control, let me show you another way to apply fades very quickly. Let's start by changing two settings. Open Preferences, go to the User tab, click on Editing. Now change your standard transition duration to 2 frames. When you start applying video transitions, you'll want to turn this up to at least 6 or 8 frames, so get used to this preference location. And save. Now, let's tell DaVinci Resolve what we want to use as our standard audio transition. On the Edit page, click Effects, Audio Transitions, and right-click on Crossfade plus 3 dB, and choose Set as Standard Transition. The default is 0 dB, which I would only use for in and out fades, but not for adjacent crossfades. The plus 3 dB crossfade is the exact same as the equal power that we looked at on the Fairlight page. I wish that Blackmagic would use the same terminology, and if you're coming from Avid, this is your dissolve midpoint attenuation. Just select all with Command A and apply the crossfades with the shortcut on the keyboard, Shift T. This is my favorite. Add audio only transition is found under the timeline menu, or you can right click on the transition in the effects panel and choose add to selected edit point and clips. Another quick tip to apply a single crossfade is to hold option and shift on the keyboard and then click and drag one clip on top of another. Then if you want to center that transition up, just right click on the transition and choose center on edit. But then if you want the crossfade to be asymmetric, you could hold Command, Control on a PC, and drag just one side of it with your mouse. This was new in 17.4. And I just want to show you that if you jump to the Fairlight page for final mixing, you can see the crossfade effects have now turned back into our editable fade shapes, and you can click and drag the white dot around to customize it. The edit page fade handles are doing the exact same thing as the audio transition crossfade from the effects panel. You just need one or the other. Now before we get on to the bonus tip about batch removing fades, I gotta say I'm so pumped that you've taken the time to watch and learn. I'm Chadwick and this channel is called Creative Video Tips. It's here to help you create videos that make a difference and stand out. Please help the channel grow by subscribing and liking it so you don't miss out on next week's tips. Sometimes you just need to delete every fade or transition, and DaVinci Resolve does not make this obvious. So here's how I get rid of all of them in just a couple of clicks. Select all the clips with Command A, Control on a PC. Now drag any transition from the effects panel onto an existing transition. This should have just selected every transition and excluded the clips underneath. Now just tap delete on your keyboard and they should be gone. And since the time left on this tutorial is about to be gone, I'm gonna point you to this playlist right here if you wanna learn more editing tips and tricks in DaVinci Resolve. And because there is so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.